Wonderful, good morning everybody. Whew. It's 6 o'clock in the morning here on the Mindful Farm, and as you can see, we are leaving. Backpack is already packed and going back to Chiang Mai. So again, another 4 hours. Actually, my plan was to go to Pai first, but now we stayed longer than planned and we're gonna continue from Chiang Mai directly over to Laos. So yeah, see you there. Ooh.
You do every day, Tina?
You should stay longer, run with us.
Yeah. It's the first day, I'm training.
Are you training first day? You yeah, do every day, Tina?
Huh?
You do every day?
No, I did not do for a year.
Not for a year. Bye bye.
See you someday.
Yes, for sure. Bye.
Bus is coming. Hello. Yes.
Right.
Hello. Good to see you again.
Good morning.
Morning.
How are you?
Hello. Good. Very good. Better and quicker and faster than the way there. The way there took us 4 hours and back now only 2.5. So it's pretty cool. We can even have breakfast now. It's only 9:30. Yep, and have some nice 2 days or 1.5 days here in Chiang Mai before we go then to Laos. Hey there, good morning guys. Today is the day. We are here at bus terminal 3 in Chiang Mai and our bus will go in like 15 minutes to go to the border to cross to Laos, and then from there we're probably gonna take one of these very slow boats to go to I will write the city down, I forgot the name already, but one of the most popular places in Laos. And yeah, it's gonna be a 6 hours bus ride and then we probably sleep somewhere overnight and cross the border in the morning, I guess. But brought plenty of good vegan healthy food to ensure that my baby is eating healthy and stays happy throughout the whole journey. And the bus, oh, the bus cost only 200 baht, by the way. And if you book a bus somewhere at the travel agencies or hostels or whatever, it would cost 1,300 baht. I mean, it's ridiculous. Just go to the bus station, terminal 3, the green bus, and book directly there and you get it for 200 baht. It's super easy. Just arrived in Chiang Kong, and actually we wanted to cross the border tonight already in order to take a transport in Laos to what is it called again? I have to link the name here, I always forget it. Luang Prabang, yes, Luang Prabang, that was it, because we want to go there tomorrow. But unfortunately there's no border crossing possible anymore, even though on the internet it says until 10 p.m. but apparently nowadays closes at 6 p.m. so we're gonna have to stay here and we have a nice little room just here to chill, and then we cross the border tomorrow and hopefully find a way to get to Luang Prabang somehow. So wonderful, good morning, it's the next day, and after the wonderful refreshing night here in this resort for 200 baht. We're gonna try to get really really early to the border so that we can travel today still to Luang Prabang. And well, now it's 6 a.m. so we try to get a tuk-tuk to the border, cross the border, and then get a tuk-tuk to the bus terminal and then get a bus. I think that was the plan for now, and that should be really really cheap. But just follow along. We still have to figure it out on the way. Alright, we just arrived at the immigration at the border, and I don't think I can actually film the border crossing, but as you can see there is literally no one. We arrived 1 hour early because we really wanted to make sure that everything works and that that we are the first to cross, as we want to continue the journey today to Luang Prabang. And yeah, I think the bus would go already quite early. We are not quite sure yet when, but the earlier we cross, the better. Yeah. Alright, now we are already through Thai immigration. It opened a little bit earlier than we thought. It's only 7:30. And now we gotta take this bus here for 25 baht to go to the Laos border. It's just over a bridge. And apparently we had to change some money into US dollar because you can only pay the visa over there in US dollar, which is a bit weird. I have to see if it's really the truth, but anyways, for now we just changed it, so should be easy enough. So crossing into Laos. But per person a little bit more expensive than I thought it's gonna be, but still half the price of this the boat would be the second option to go to Luang Prabang, and it costs 1,000 baht per person, and it takes 2 days, and the bus only takes 1 day, so 12 hours. Hello. Yeah, but 12 hours, this is gonna be comfortable, huh? It's like lying chairs.
Mom, upstairs with me, nice bed.
Looks like something on the bus broke down. We have no idea what, but everybody left the bus again after the break, and yeah, now we are stuck here in the middle of nowhere. We are the only tourists, no one speaks English, so let's see if we might need to change the bus or if they can continue on this bus. No idea. So I know you can't see a damn thing right now of me or of anything, but it's in the middle of the night. It's 10:30. We should have arrived half an hour ago, but we are still 80 kilometers away from where we are supposed to go, and that's because there might have been probably what is an accident, and we are stuck, and there's like, I don't know, 100 cars and trucks and buses just lined up waiting, and I don't know how long it takes. Could take until the morning as well, I don't know, because we're in the middle of nowhere, somewhere in Laos. I found a little bit of light for this one now. Yeah, it's 1 a.m. we were supposed to arrive at 10 and it's still nothing moving. I mean, if you can see it behind me, this is a truck. And I think everybody just resigned. Like, everybody is sleeping, all the bus drivers, all the truck drivers, the whole traffic is just sleeping, even if there would be the obstacles removed, which I think are already removed, we are not sure, but there was already someone told. Yeah, everybody's just sleeping. I just recently heard someone telling me that in China there's actually traffic jams which last like 5 to 10 days because people are just falling asleep and it takes forever to get everybody going again. And it looks like we are in this kind of situation. But of course it won't take 10 days, it will just take until tomorrow morning, I guess. So I'm spending the night somewhere in the middle of a mountain road here in Laos in a bus. And 7 months pregnant. Ah, you can't see it, of course. But yeah, not the most comfortable place to be. But I make the best out of it. It's a once in a lifetime experience, I hope at least. So have a good night. All right, it's the next morning. It's 10 a.m. now. And we have to change our approach. I mean, Nick and I were just deciding to hitchhike now to Luang Prabang because we just found out that this traffic jam is already going on for 24 hours and there is no sign of anything moving whatsoever, and we just can't stand here another day, so we're just gonna grab our stuff from the bus and try to walk out of this traffic jam and try to hitchhike with one of the smaller cars. Yeah, I mean, that's our best bet, and then we hopefully make it today to Luang Prabang. This is what caused the problem, a landslide, and just gonna walk to the other side and hope to catch a ride there. So motorcycles can still go through.
There's no way it could go through.
Yes. So now we are on the other side of the jam. Now we just need to see how far we need to walk to get to the end of this. So I'm not sure if you can see me right now, but we just found this petrol station just here, and that's just outside of the traffic jam. And so we are hoping to catch a ride here, but we probably will end up to catch a motorbike. I like two motorbikes because there's more motorbikes going through than anything else.
And he's going to Luang Prabang.
Yes, and he's fast. So we now walked around 2 hours down the road and finally we were able to catch a ride. We're not sure if the road opened or if this guy just turned around, but a bunch of scooters came through at the same time, so there might be a small gap for people to pass through again. But yeah, now it should be not so much longer for us to reach Luang Prabang, but we also heard from many people that there is the bridge collapsed right in front of Luang Prabang, so maybe we have to figure out something there again.
Thank you.
latest here we would have had to change our transport.
But it would take days until they organized something.
He's just pushing the whole ferry with one stick. With one stick he pushes like 10 cars. It's so cool. $250, but I can put the dollar price here as well. I think it's like, I put the dollar price. Anyways, now we are in Luang Prabang. Finally just relaxing here. And maybe tomorrow we check out the waterfalls. So, thanks so much for watching. And don't forget to subscribe if you like my channel. Stay happy, stay healthy, and stay tuned. And see you guys soon. Bye bye.